this place to Mr. Farmer. We are one of the oldest nursery people who have started in Goa when nobody wanted to buy plants. In fact, I'll tell you this also, I like to tell this to people. Somebody came up to me, "We have to buy the plants." I got a shock, you know. I said, "Yes, because I'll tell you why. Goans are used to coming to your house. They should break, no, what the? After breaking, not before. No permission. But that was a tradition. I'm not saying that is something wrong. But it's okay. So it took a little time for us to make people understand and develop this. My first nursery was around my house. Now we are here for many years. Here the benefit is that people passing by, they know there is a nursery, they walk in. So we have grown from 1974 to till date. And what we try to do, always improve upon not only the plants, we keep collecting the rarer plants, so that people, when they come here, not only they get plants, we have also added other things which are required for gardening, like pots. We'll walk there, and so under one roof you get everything. Otherwise, what happens? It's like when you go to some shop, Sakar Asana, you go somewhere else, it becomes very irritating, you know.
So what range you have, Mr. Mendonca? Apart from plants, what else?
We have pots, manures, fertilizers, we have pesticides, and art effects also. We create
appliances.
We will go there.
Implements
we have. So it becomes easy. Come here, shop everything and go.
What's this?
This is poinsettia, Christmas flower.
Poinsettia.
This is a famous now.
I see.
People buy this. We don't grow this. We buy and we trade in this. We buy and sell this. Because it's not possible to get this color in Goa.
I see.
Because, because of climate. And to get color for this, no, you have to give them more darkness. You have to absolutely in the dark, you have to keep for almost 18 hours, 20 hours, per day. Otherwise, they don't turn like this red. First when I brought this plant, some years, 50 years ago, so I thought, I was excited. Then I made more plants. I said, next year I will have more red or green. But they grow luxuriantly here. They grow very well. They become very big.
But they remain green the next year.
No, they do get red if the climate is good. But I don't think in future we'll get better climate than that time. You know what is happening now.
So maybe you should keep them in the shade.
No. Shade, no. This light, no. You make them dark, pitch dark.
When you say better climate, what do you mean?
This is humid climate. Like Pune, Bangalore is a dry climate. They love that. So every time we bring, people buy this and they chuck them out. Because keeping them is no use for the next year. Though some people still keep. But they come back and say, my plant has not turned. Giving red.
I have two of them.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, what has happened is they started not dying, but they started shedding. Because keep it in my living room, but the AC is on a lot of the time.
No, first thing, don't keep anything inside the house. Because of light or anything, they get suffocated. But there are some plants which stay longer, like pothos, the money plant we call it. They stay longer. I'm not saying that is the best. Avoid keeping in a bedroom or in the house. But I have seen some areas, some of my friends, who have got very high roofs like this.
Yeah.
They stay there longer, but you have to give little sunlight. I've seen them growing even ferns, doing very well. But this little care you have to take. Avoid keeping anything inside. And also, one must judge how much each plant, how much light, how much fertilizer, whether to use fertilizer or compost. But there are some plants hate compost, they rot. So you have to be careful. So that is the experience we give. You know, we do have workshops here, which I'm going to conduct. I will invite all of you, must attend that. You have to come and dirty your hands. You know, then only you experience the feel of the plant, of the soil. Otherwise, you get everything on the YouTube.
It's all theory.
There is some practical, yeah. But when you
do it,
yeah, and you kill one plant, and you know next time how to save it. You know, there are simple things, I cannot cover everything, like transplanting of, from the bag to a pot. Sometimes you break that ball of earth, we call it, around. Yeah. If that thing breaks, then what you do? Plant droops. Immediately you can treat, you know, you have to hospitalize them.
ICU.
Yeah, ICU. You can save the plants like this. So this we will tell you when we have workshop.
Yeah.
And now coming to some of the plants that you see here. Can you see this? I like this plant very much. You know, we have two types. One is plain green. The bottom is red.
Yes.
Yes. And it is flowering already. It's too tiny. Another 10 days, beautiful flower.
Which is that?
This is Clarendon, one of the species of Clarendon, and very tropical, and also you can be sure whatever we sell here are only tropical plants. We don't trade in plants just because there is a business, bring it here and sell it. In fact, this gentleman was asking me just now.
You wouldn't know the species?
I know the species.
Clarendon,
yeah. It is species starts with Q. I have that, I'll give you. Quadri, something, I'll let you know.
Okay.
This gentleman was asking, I don't know him, first time I met him. So he was choosing plants. So he was choosing a plant which was not actually good for the container that he had chosen. I said, don't buy this. I said, then he saw, I also didn't know the price that time. That was almost twice the price what he is buying. I said, this is not the plant for you, for these containers. If you want, take a bigger container, then you can take it. See, it is not just selling. We feel happier when you go home and you call us, Baba, your plant is doing well. People come and tell me about old plants. That time I used to, myself used to graft mangoes. These are called air plants. They don't require actually water.
They don't require anything.
Yeah.
Just they grow like that.
And we also have some
there. That one also.
Yeah.
That's another air plant.
Yeah. So they absorb moisture directly from the thing. Yeah. Now these are poinsettias I spoke to you. We'll just pass through. These are the all calatheas or marantas. You can call both.
Yeah, maranta.
Then this homolomena.
Ah, this is homolomena.
Homolomena. There are at least 50 varieties. As we go, I will show you some more. So this is what people want as a potted plant. I just heard you saying Joe, no?
This is maranta.
This is maranta, calathe. They are almost same, very close to each other. You know that word indoor, no, is very dangerous, I'll tell you. Shade loving plant is the right word.
Yeah.
Because when there was a fight here, I mean, this girl said indoor plant.
Like this, no?
That he kept in his bedroom and killed. He says, you didn't tell us.
If you put it inside the house, it dies off. Those spider plant, that one.
Any plant will die, except money plant.
Shade loving plant.
Yeah.
The right word.
Yeah. Shade loving plant is the right thing. Now, this is something we do quite often. These are. That's a fern.
Yeah, that's a fern.
There are hundreds of ferns here, varieties. These are all ferns what you see on top. The rarest is this and that one.
Yeah.
Very rare, and this one. Because Krishna said, I have this.
You have a tree fern, no?
Yeah, tree fern. I have both. The tropical is this, but I have the other
fern
also. It's growing very well in my house. So this fern is very, very rare. Now, if I leave it here, this leaf will grow, it will touch the ground.
See this.
In fact,
these are the spores.
Yeah.
These are the spores. See, you can see the black color dots.
I see.
Those are the spores. Those, when they fall, they will make it to a new plant.
You can grow them in the lab also. We need a special agar media, we call it. Sterilize, and you can use spores. They're like seeds. They sprout so tiny there.
Yeah,
you have to be very careful. And then you can get this many plants. Now tissue culture has become a very popular thing. And see, this is called a bamboo palm. You can see these, they look like bamboos.
Yeah.
So
see the inflorescence.
See the what? Sorry.
Inflorescence.
From here you'll get some seeds.
Coconuts you get.
Yeah. And we use those seeds to multiply. These are the babies of these. Some people prefer a small plant.
And this one is a bonsai, I think.
No, it's not a bonsai.
One?
You know, see, the idea people want for some time.
Yeah.
So they take it for Christmas, New Year, then they go back to Delhi, the plant is here only and die. So
but
people, this is not the same palm, another palm.
This will grow how tall, bamboo?
This grows to almost maximum, this is the maximum height.
This is the maximum.
Yeah.
You get much bigger ones, no?
Oh, palms?
Yeah, those are different variety.
Yeah.
This is a different one.
We'll walk out, I'll show you.
Yeah.
But I think we'll finish this.
Yeah, whatever.
A little bit,
whatever you want.
So these are caladiums, which lots of people like because of their color.
How much are they? Modern ones.
That we'll do our business afterwards.
You need more color.
Yeah. Come.
And these?
See, these are dwarf plants. Can you minutely see their flowering now?
Moraya exotica.
Yeah. Moraya exotica.
Moraya exotica dwarf. Yeah.
And Moraya. That will become white completely after some time.
Gets flowers.
There are three types. One is tall, one semi-dwarf, and this is the...
Yeah, buds are coming.
Lots of buds, You know, in plant kingdom, there are too much of
variety.
This is a water plant, I think.
Yeah, no, this is not a water plant.
It's not a water plant?
These are apiaceous. There are many more varieties which are not here. Some of the rarest I have at home, I sell maybe two plants here, but very expensive they are. These are cheap.
I thought this was water.
No, these are succulents, you know.
Yeah.
But
is this not Brahmi?
No.
No. Apiaceous do well in Goa, very tropical. No. What is important in apiaceous is your water control. Marantas also, little excess water is gone.
So with the heavy monsoons, how you manage?
The type of media we use, more sand we put in that.
Okay.
If you are keeping outdoor, if it's under greenhouse, then we don't bother.
Okay.
But the kind of rain that we have now, with the humidity is 100% for 10 days, without watering plants die.
I see.
Without watering.
I have lost a couple of plants this year. You know, but what? Anyway, you can't help it. Some plants do die. This is euphorbias.
Euphorbia mealy.
No, this is not mealy. Mealy is a tiny flower. In euphorbia also, there are many more varieties today.
Which is this one then?
Species, I forgot. Yeah. See, this is a new Cryptanthus. You know, this is a very rare plant. The you get usually red, I don't know whether we have. Red, pink. But I'll show you. Most of the plants here are propagated by us. But we trade in some plants like these because people want in miniature this thing, you know. this is a the jade. Become very popular now, succulent plant. People right. Even they call this succulent. This is not succulent actually, yeah. But
it is like a bromeliad.
Like a bromeliad. Yeah.
It looks like the pineapple family. It's not.
That this.
This is very close to.
I collected this from Lana.
Yeah, there are two, three colors here.
What's the name? I forget the name.
Did I tell you? You know, I'm also forgetting names now. It. Getting old.
I collected from Mahabaleshwar. Yeah.
This is also a very beautiful flower. They are going to flower, you know. This is an old plant,
yeah.
But not available.
I can't get the name.
Chrysothemis purcella.
Yeah.
This is a very nice plant. And flowers throughout the year.
Yeah.
It likes a good amount of sunlight also. Now this is Ixora I had planted at home actually, in a big pot for myself. Then my boy at home, my gardener, he said, sir, please take it. It's going to be nice, you can sell it. So I said, okay, your sake, I'll take it. And see, these are coleus. They always give color to your garden. And you can just break
and
a small...
mix them also, when they are mixed. In
very nice. We do have another 10 varieties. You know,
coleus.
You know, this plant.
But you must not allow them to flower.
You must be. You know, this particular plant is called Xanthosoma. Yeah. And this is the first time available, you know, so much.
Which one?
Xanthosoma.
This one?
Yeah, first time it is available.
What's like, this now? See, so tiny.
This, I think this is Alternatera.
This is
I'm not sure. You tell the name.
Is there some name?
It's like Andrographis type. It's from the Andrographis family. Andrographis type.
Because I want some botanists to come and identify plants. Yeah. I know, but she has to send a team.
I'm retired now, so I...
Good job for you. We pay you for doing that.
What do you say, this one?
Xanthosoma. XA. Yeah. Very beautiful plant, potted plant. Mm. I have myself, I don't sell them, I want to enjoy them. Right. Big ones I have at home. Sometimes it pains me to sell, you know. I'm too attached to it.
Yeah.